Hi YouTube, this is Francis, and I'm getting on again to do another video. I'm uploading multiple today, and this one is going to be the transitioners tag. And I actually saw it on Music Butterfly Cocoon's page. She did her version of the transitioners tag that she saw on someone else's page. So here goes mine. I'm going to try not to ramble too much. I don't want this to be too long, so bear with me. Okay, what motivated me to take a step toward natural hair? Actually, I didn't plan on going natural. Like, I did not have any thought in my head about being natural. I actually, you know, was like 8-9 months in to transition, and I didn't even realize it. I just knew that my hair was like getting, you know, really wavy, and the texture was starting to change, like at the roots, and it was like a lot thicker. So I wasn't actually trying to go natural. I was actually just trying to give my hair a break from the relaxers and the straighteners and just everything. So I started, you know, doing the little bantu knot outs and all of that type of stuff. And then around my 9th month, I actually, you know, got on YouTube and started seeing the beautiful natural hair world and hair care, and I just fell headfirst into it, and here I am now. How many months total do I plan to transition? I am currently at 13 months post. November 5th will be 14 months post, and I would really, really love to transition for 24 months total, because I want to retain some length before I do my big chop. I am very concerned about the health of my hair, which my hair is very healthy right now, but I'm not used to short hair, and I know that I would not be comfortable, you know, with short hair. And I mean, I keep saying short hair, but I mean, even now transitioning at 13 months post, it's like past my ear, but I'm still not comfortable with that length. I've always had like shoulder length or longer hair. So yeah, 24 months is where I would love to transition to. What do I enjoy most about transitioning? So far, just learning how to take care of my hair. I can't remember when I was younger, and even when my mom used to do my hair, like I remember she would just kind of do random things to my hair. I got a relaxer at, I believe, age 7, because she said that my hair was like too curly and too thick, and I mean, she had 2 other girls, so it was hard for her to manage by herself, and we didn't go to a salon, so she didn't really trust people with our hair. So yeah, I enjoy just learning how to take care of it. I enjoy seeing my natural pattern. I enjoy trying to figure out, you know, what's my hair type, because, you know, transitioning, you go through a variety of hair types. You have basically all of them. But yeah, I enjoy the hair care, the texture, the health, the shine, the bounciness. Because when I was relaxed, my hair was always rather, I wouldn't say dull, but you know, really, you know, most relaxers, you want them really flat and no body and no bounce and, you know, straight to your head. So yeah, I love the bounce about it. What do I enjoy least about transitioning? Okay, first of all, when I was at like 8-9 months and I wasn't thinking of going natural, I was just, you know, already transitioning, I was so frustrated. I was so frustrated. I was pissed off at myself and my hair. I'm like, dang, why can't I just relax? But then I started seeing my curl pattern. I was just like, well, maybe I should, maybe I shouldn't. And really, I was really frustrated all the way up until like my year marker for transition. And, you know, I have my days now of being very, very frustrated with the fact that my hair, I'm not used to my hair being big. You know, when you do either a twist out, braid out, bench knot, I'm not used to my hair, you know, being big and fluffy. So that's one thing I have to get used to. I'm not used to having to try and style my hair every 2 or 3 days. You know, when you're relaxed, you just perm it, grease it, throw it back in a ponytail, or wear it down. That's it. So yeah, that's what I like least about it, having to, you know, doing multiple styles, maybe every week, every 2 weeks, whatever. And just being frustrated on those days when your hair does not act right. That's about it. If I could give one tip to someone transitioning, what would it be? Be patient. Pray. Pray, be patient. And understand that just like everything in life, transitioning to natural is a process. Like, some people, you know, you could big chop and, you know, be there quicker. But with transitioning, it's a moment to, you know, learn, you know, what type of person you are through, you know, your hair. You know, learn how God made you, how God made your hair to grow out of your scalp. Like, it starts to change you into a different person. Like, not really a different person, but it shows a different side of you. So just be patient, pray, understand that it's a process, and most of all, don't ever let anyone tell you that you should not be transitioning to natural, you should not want to be natural, because it's just bogus. It's really just bogus. I mean, natural hair is what God gave us, so why wouldn't you want or be, you know, natural? So just do what you feel you want to do. Be true to you. 5 favorite long-term transitioners, and I had to write these down. Number 1 would be Miss Kiara Dean. I really love her honesty. I really love, you know, her just overall. I love her hair care regimen. I love how strict she is. And I love how personal she can get, you know, about what she do, what she don't like. And she knows herself and her hair very well. Natural 85, oh my God, I am freaking in love with her. I love everything about her. I love her hair. I love her tutorials. I love, you know, how personal she is and how open and honest she is. So yeah, her. 007 Nunu, I love her and her daughter. I love their stories. I love that they had patience and they did it together and they inspired each other. I freaking love them. They are awesome. Fusion of Cultures. I love her. I freaking love her. She is awesome. She's so honest and open. And I love her tutorials. I love her accent. Like, most of all, she's just a really nice, you know, YouTuber, natural YouTuber, and I love watching her. I love watching her old videos. And most of all, number 5, I freaking love this person, Kiki Couture 10. Oh my gosh, I love this girl. I have went back and watched every last one of her videos from way back when she first started up until now. I mean, I freaking love her. I love how blunt she is. I love the fact that she, you know, tells it like it is. She don't take no smack from nobody. She knows herself. She knows what she is and what she isn't. I mean, I just love everything about her. Like, her hair journey is so amazing. And, you know, she's still having big chops, so it's still continuing. So, yeah, my 5 favorites are Miss Kiara Dean, Natural 85, 007 Nunu, Fusion of Cultures, and most of all, Kiki Couture. Okay. Name 3 styles perfect for transitioners. For transitioners in general, I can't say before myself. 1, my hair does not like some styles. Or maybe it's just that, you know, I don't like the way it looks in the styles. But the perfect transition style, 3 top ones, would be bun, puff, and braid outs. I love, love, love braid outs. I love how they look on my head. I love the puff. I love the messy bun. I love it, love it, love it. What is your go-to transition style? Most of all, it's a messy bun or a low messy bun. Or braid out. That's about it. I mean, like I said, right now I'm trying a different style as we can see. But I haven't, you know, played around with too many styles as of yet. My transitioning hair loves deep conditioner. Oh, my hair loves deep conditioner. Oh, it just loves it, loves it, loves it. It is just so pretty and soft and bouncy, and just, my scalp feels awesome. So yeah, my natural transition hair loves deep conditioner, and my transitioning hair hates twist outs. Twist outs, I hate them on my hair because, one, I don't like the way that, you know, they look on my hair. I don't like the fact that it's so much manipulation to my hair. I just don't like them. If I could do it all over again, would I long-term transition? Yes, I would. My only difference would be that I would pay attention to it from the beginning. Like I said, I didn't really start taking care of my hair until I was around 8 months natural. Well, transitioning, I should say. So yeah, I would do it all over again. And who is my natural hair crush? Okay. Of all the naturals out there in natural hair land, there are two that I absolutely, absolutely love. The first one I really like is Mahogany Knot. I love everything about her page. She is just so funny. And then she's not always, you know, strict with her hair care regimen. She experiments with this and that. And I love that about her, but she really takes care of her hair. She really knows her hair. And she really doesn't waste time to tell you, okay, if you've seen one tutorial like this, you're seeing them all. That's my first one. And my absolute favorite hair crush, natural hair crush, has to be Mahogany Curls. Her hair is so, like, beautiful. Even though she BC'd, I absolutely love her hair. I love everything about her hair. I love the definition of it. I love the way she styles it. I love the way it hangs. I just love everything about her hair. I love it, love it, love it. So yeah, that is my version of the transitioner tag. Thanks for watching. Comment, rate, and or subscribe. And also, go check out my new channel. It's Miss Red Wine 86. That's MRSREDWINE 86. Thanks.